Hi, my name is Patricia Miller, and I'm a sculptor and grad student at Cal State San Bernardino. I create abstract plywood sculptures depicting my experience with anxiety and depression, ultimately promoting mental health awareness in the end. I use the plywood to represent the human figure and show the wear and tear of life has on the body, mentally, physically, internally, and I want to show what it's like to reach one's breaking point. And since I'm referencing the human body, sometimes it's hard to get that across looking at a full sheet of plywood. So cutting it down to a smaller size and mimicking the body, the head curved in as like a fetal position, the feet, it better explains what I'm trying to get across as far as feeling fragile, unstable, vulnerable, unbroken. So it took destroying one of my paintings that I did on plywood to reveal all of the beauty within the material that no one sees. And if they do see, they discard it and don't appreciate it like I do. And I feel like digging into the material also relates to like digging in myself and like revealing the layers within myself and just like the story within the material and within myself that I'm putting on display to the world. Each piece is unique, just like each person is unique, and you never know what to expect. And sometimes I find myself getting a little frustrated because I expect a piece to come off easier or chip off easier, and it's not. But I just have to like be content with that and know that that is what is making this piece unique and different to any other piece. I look to see if there's like any imperfections because I know those pieces are going to tear apart more easily, and it's going to show the glue that's within the piece that I find really interesting. I work with either the full size 8x4 sheet of plywood, or sometimes I cut it down and work a smaller size, and once I tear it apart to a thin sheet, I soak it with a hose, which allows it to bend more easily without breaking, and then I bend and break it into different forms or silhouettes, hopefully to better resemble like a human figure and what I want to get across. I lay them out on the ground. I prefer to work on a hard surface. It's very like natural and animalistic to like crawl across my artwork and tear it apart. I use a specific hammer that has a rubber face to it because I found that using anything different caused too much vibration and such a harsh impact that wrecked my arms and hands while I was hammering away. So using the rubber, it minimizes that type of impact and vibration. And I use a flathead screwdriver that's very long that I could get deep in between the layers and tear it apart. Tools that are very unique and not typically used, but I find that nothing works better than these to do what I need to do. My experience with how to prevent injuries has just been trial and error, so I've definitely hit my hand all the time with the hammer, so my gloves and the fact that they're thick and rubber on the palm is very helpful to prevent any hand injuries and also like splinters, because I used to get the worst, biggest splinters ever that I wish I documented because they were just crazy. And I wear like long sleeves, long pants, shoes, because I also like use my hands and get in between the layers to like pry apart, and I've like scraped up my arms and legs and everything. So I've just kind of have a uniform now that I wear to make my work. I never thought about the danger of making my work because I usually make it by myself in an open space. I'm a person that likes nature. Obviously, I work with wood, so I like to be outside and outdoors in the fresh air with the breeze and the birds. And so it was just like natural to me to make my work outside. It's also like very large pieces that need an ample amount of room of me to like work around and walk around. And I like to lift it up and put it against the wall and then get some distance from it, because as an artist, you need to see like how it looks overall. At the end, I like to collect all of the debris and leftover pieces. I try to make my work as zero waste as possible, and I use those pieces to create other work. As far as one of my pieces called All Better Now, I use the debris and glued it together to kind of create a full sheet of plywood to resemble when your life falls apart from some traumatic event and you're left picking up the pieces of your life and putting yourself back together, but still feeling fragile and kind of in denial of being all better now. So I like to incorporate every aspect of the plywood. I feel like I like have a hard work ethic and like a very DIY process driven art techniques that really shine more with sculpture than any other process. That being said, I have to deal with the elements. It's very windy and then it rains. So sometimes I do work indoors, but that's rare. And I also just enjoy the sound that my work makes outdoors and like the echoes. People think my process is therapeutic, but it's kind of exhausting and frustrating. And it brings up like sometimes my anxiety when I'm like making my work, but I don't know if that's necessarily a bad thing, you know? And I think I'm always going to deal with anxiety. It's something that you have to just come to terms with and embrace. And I think the more you do that, the easier it is to get through the moment and deal with it. And I feel like the end result and seeing it displayed in a gallery or getting the type of feedback that I do get is worth any struggle that I go through when making the piece. It can be a form of exercise. I mean, my hands get sore if I haven't done it in a while, and maybe my back or my legs, but I feel like it's better for me because coming from drawing, I was always so hunched over. My back would hurt even more from doing something less physical than this, which is interesting. So I went to Palm Elementary School, which is an art magnet school. And so I enjoyed creating and doing dioramas and drawing any time that I could for any project. And then I was finally able to take art classes when I got into Cajon High School as my elective. So I took ceramics and drawing, and I actually almost failed my drawing class because I couldn't follow directions and like the rules of what needed to be done for each project. I just wanted the creative freedom to do whatever I wanted. And that's when I really spent most of my time focused on art. I think like most of my life I spent focused on drawing, just like the realm of 2D. And it wasn't until I started like undergrad here, and as a studio art major, they require you to go outside of your comfort zone and take different types of classes. And I really got to be more creative in all different types of mediums, which made moving on from drawing easier or more natural. I became such a perfectionist over drawing and being as detailed and technically skilled and realistic as I could be. It totally made me not enjoy art as much. And so finding this material that relieved that pressure and expectations and just like the beauty of the happy accidents just made me fall in love with art again. I think like completing my MFA made me feel like I could finally call myself an artist. And being an artist, I feel a sense of pride and purpose for my life, because I feel like if anybody should represent San Bernardino and talk about San Bernardino, it should be the artists of San Bernardino, because as an artist, you are able to look at your surroundings in a different way and have a different appreciation by using, I think, a more visual universal language that relates across the world and different demographics and diversity of cultures and races, which I think is why art is so important to San Bernardino, because San Bernardino is such a culturally and racially diverse city to live in, and each person has such a unique perspective of growing up in San Bernardino, what that's like, and art is able to tell their story, and you just see the endless possibilities and opportunities that are around you, whether to like create art out of, or to capture, to document, to explain and share with the world. I just think it's like really important to never give up, because I feel like I've found something that I haven't seen before that's been done, and it's unique, and it's made me feel like proud of like who I am and my personal experiences in life. And just the fact that this all wouldn't exist if I didn't exist is something I always need to remind myself. And I think it's like really important to just give yourself some credit sometimes, because you never know what you'll make next or what creations you'll come across or influences you're gonna have on somebody. And I think it's really powerful and meaningful.